our morning rounds, your sinuses under pressure. Sinus problems affect about 31 million Americans. They lead to around 16 million doctor visits a year. With high pollen counts this spring, it could be tough to know if you're suffering from a sinus infection, allergies, or a cold. Dr. Lisa Liberatore is a sinus specialist at Lenox Hill Hospital here in New York and joins us now. Good morning.
Good morning.
And that is my very question. How do you know? Is it sinuses? Is it allergies or just a cold?
Well, very often you can think back last year and say, hey, did I feel like this last year? If you did, it's probably allergies. So allergies this time of year actually struck a little earlier,
right,
because of the winter, mild winter. So a cold usually will last about 7 days or less, and it's usually feel body aches all over. You don't feel so well. Allergies can also make you not feel well, but typically you'll notice the symptoms will continue and accompanied with chills. With sneezing, itching eyes, watery eyes. Typical
Wouldn't you
for
know
allergies.
You have an allergy by adulthood?
You know, people say, I don't have allergies, and that's because they don't realize that you can develop allergies over time. So people who have been tested for allergies years ago, maybe, 5 to 10 years ago, can have new allergies now, especially people moving from other parts of the world, come here, or different parts of the United States will have different things that didn't affect them in there.
Physiologically, describe what happens with a sinus headache, a sinus infection.
So most people don't realize how many sinuses we have. There's four regions of the sinuses, across the forehead, in the cheeks, between the eyes, and then a deep sinus. And all those sinuses are supposed to be filled with air. And the sinuses also secrete mucus, which drain into little openings. And it's pretty easy for those little openings to get closed, either by excess mucus or by blockage from your anatomy that you're either born with or you develop over time.
And that's what causes the headache?
Right. So if the sinuses can't drain properly, then you're going to get headaches, either usually over the area where the sinus is affected.
And so what's the best treatment then for a sinus infection?
Well, certainly if you have allergies or you're prone to allergies, prevention is always important. So you want to try to keep the sinuses draining, right? So you want to keep the free flow of mucus either by irrigating.
Hopefully not when we're on the air.
Right. So, yeah.
I mean, good breakfast talk.
I know. See, my people like this talk,
Really
I know it's hard for the morning, but basically salt water. Salt water rinses are really good, just to kind of keep things going.
Thank you, Dr. Liberatore.
You're welcome. Yeah.